So this next question is something that I've actually addressed in several of my other videos, but I still keep getting questions in the comments saying, how do I wire up a forward and reverse switch?
Greetings, fellow DIYer, and welcome to my video.
And so rather than making you wade through all my other videos, I'm going to do this video on specifically how to wire a reverse switch for a treadmill motor. As with so many of my other videos, we are working with electricity. If you are not qualified to work with electricity, you can really hurt yourself. So use this information at your own risk. So the first question you might have is, why would I want to be able to run my treadmill motor in reverse? Well, it depends on your application. The treadmill motor that I have set up on my mill only ever has to run one direction. So there's no reason to have a reverse switch. But on my lathe, it's very important. You know, if you're cutting reverse threads, if you're threading in general, because the way my machine works, I have to use the spindle in reverse after winding out the carriage to get it back to the starting point. So on the lathe, it's very important. So the first thing we need to look at is, can my motor even run in reverse? Most treadmill motors can run in forward and reverse. All DC type motors are technically able to run in reverse. All you have to do is change the polarity. So if you hook up positive to the red and negative to the black, it's going to run in the direction that it says it runs on the label. If you hook up positive to the black and negative to the red, it's going to run in the opposite direction. The important thing to know is some treadmill motors are set up with the brushes at a different angle. So the brushes on this motor come into the motor equal to each other. So let's say that this is the contact point that they are hitting inside. Obviously, this is a flywheel. This is not the inside of a motor. But these brushes come in perpendicular to the part that they rub on inside the motor. And that allows it to run in either direction without any problem. But some brush configurations come in like this. And in that particular case, it can be very hard on the brushes to run in reverse. Most treadmill motors are set up like this and can totally be used. Now, the easiest way to tell is just to simply spin it by hand. As long as it feels roughly the same both directions and it's not catching one direction, then your motor can be run in reverse. Now, a motor that's seen a lot of hours and has been used quite a bit, there might be a slightly different feel in reverse compared to going forward, but for the most part, they're going to be the same both directions. And if you have one of the motors where the brushes are set up like that, you'll know immediately. I mean, it will definitely not feel right when you're going the wrong direction. Now, the second thing that's really important in determining if you can run your motor in reverse is whether or not it's a thread-on shaft or if it's a keyway shaft. The motor that's being used on my mill has a keyway, so I can run it in either direction, no problem, no modification. This is a thread-on shaft. So if we thread the shaft on, how about if I go the right direction? We thread the shaft on, the motor goes clockwise like it's supposed to, those threads are gonna stay tight. If we run it in reverse, this is gonna spin off. And so that can be a problem. Now there are several ways to fix that, one of which is to use Loctite. All of these little motors that I've taken from treadmills, the flywheel is actually Loctited on. So as long as you haven't heated this to remove the flywheel, you should be able to run it in forward and reverse without any problem. Another option would be to drill a hole in this, thread it, and run a set screw down. That could help hold it. But that to me is a lot of work, and you run the risk of damaging the threads inside. So personally, I like the concept of just simply using the Loctite. It works extremely well, it's not going to come loose, and you'll be able to run that motor in reverse. So now that we've determined our motor works in reverse, how do we actually wire it? Well, this right here is a double pull, double throw switch, center off. And the center off is extremely important because they make double pull, double throw switches that are on, on. So you flip it this way and it's on. It doesn't have a stop in the middle like this one. It just immediately goes to the other direction and it's on. And if you're going one direction and you flip it the other direction, you are going to, one, damage your brushes, at least shorten their life, and two, you run the risk of stalling the motor. And when you stall a motor, it's extremely hard on your power supply. So you can burn up things, especially if you're using the MC2100, but that's a different video. It's extremely important that we use an on, off, on, double pull, double throw switch. It needs to be fairly high amperage, because these motors draw high amperage. And when you're using it, you need to let everything come to a stop before switching directions. So if I'm going one direction, I'm making some cuts on my lathe, let's say I'm threading, I get to the runout gutter, I turn it off. I let everything come to a stop. I wind out my carriage, I go the other direction. Once I get to the point where I want the cutter to be, I go to the off position, I let it come to a stop. So how you use it is as important as to what type of switch it is. Now, the way a double pull, double throw switch works is it's basically two switches. You have this half, these three terminals, and you have this half, these three terminals. What these three terminals are doing is only related to these three terminals in that they're both getting switched at the same time. Now, the way it's gonna work is this center terminal on both sides is what we're being switched to. So either this is getting connected to this, or this is getting connected to this. And the same is true on this side. These center terminals are the ones that go to our motor. Red is gonna go to red, black is gonna go to black. Now I made nice long leads on this just for illustration's sake. When you actually put it in your lathe or other device, you're gonna wanna clean it up and do something probably similar to this, but we'll get back to that. So, when the switch is switched this way, it's connecting the center terminal to this side. We flip it over, it's connecting the center terminal to this side. So, the center terminal is getting connected to the terminal that basically the paddle is pointing at. Now, not all switches are like that. Sometimes switching it that way will connect these two terminals, but all the center off ones that I've ever seen, flipping it that direction connects it to this terminal. In this configuration, we're connecting the middle to this outside, so black to black. If we flip it over, we are connecting red to red. Center two wires, they go to the motor. This red wire and this red wire go to your positive on your power supply. On the other side, center black wire goes to the motor, and this black wire and this black wire go to the negative on your power supply. In this configuration, black is going to black, red is going to red. So the motor will go in the direction that is labeled on the motor. It'll say clockwise or counterclockwise. Whatever the motor says, we're connecting red to red, and it's gonna go that direction. Turn it off, let everything come to a stop. We flip it the other direction. Now we are connecting the red from the motor to the negative on the power supply. And we are connecting the black from the motor to the positive on the power supply. And that will reverse the direction of your motor. And that's all there is to it. So I could take and connect these wires together, these two outside reds, and I could connect these two outside blacks together and hook them to my power supply, but that's a lot of wires and that's a lot of mass. So that's why I have this right here. Again, the two center terminals go to the motor. The two outside terminals are red and black. And it's very simple, we got the power coming in. And then it works the exact same way. And that's all it takes to reverse the direction of your treadmill motor.
If you like what you've seen, please click like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.